पावर ट्रांसफर इक्वेशंस ट्रांसफरिंग पावर फ्रॉम सेंडिंग इट टू रिसीविंग नियर टू रिसीविंग एंड सेंड वी आर राइटिंग द इक्वेशन दैट्स व्हाई दिस इक्वेशन इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज रिसीविंग एंड power transfer equation.
So receiving end loads, receiving end means load. Load is taking what type of power?
Active power is taking, reactive power is taking.
Both the powers are there. That's why we have the equation
for active power and also for reactive power. So if we analyze the structure of transmission line, transmission is always transferred from what? Source. We are going to connect it to bus bar. From that bus bar to one of the connecting to load. What type of loads are having inductive loads? So inductive loads you might be referring to this in one case. Now load is what parameters are there? VR and VR. What force it is getting? Active power and reactive power. So at some of these two numbers what operand power? Active power for J, QR, reactive power. Similarly, supply voltage is here. Supply voltage in the registration is working directly now. Angle delta. Yes, the angle delta is very unique as we discussed basis. Delta, why? Because delta is the angle between rotor rotating axis to synchronously reference frame delta. So loading this delta also increases in number ready for it. And here, sending in active power plus J, sending in reactive power. So supply current. So load is anything reactive power. Receiving end power is not applying in 0 because it is induction motor. Because the difference between rotor speed and stator speed, we are going to be running with the slip. That's it. We are running in 0, we will specify. Now,
so what expression we are going to use to reference for active power? Power is equal to
VI conjugated. VI conjugated means that this is the percent of variance. Load receives reactive power to inductive loads and the load delivers reactive power for capacitive loads. Load is capacitive. It will deliver the reactive power to the transmission line. If load is inductive load, L load, it will take the reactive power. Because inductive load means to create a flux, it needs to take reactive power. This is the power required to create flux is called reactive power. The power required to create a flux is called reactive power. So that will take the power. Now this VI conjugate represents complex power. Complex power means it will represent how much amount of active power and the reactive power we have sent to the loads. Now, so if we write the ABCD parameters for any transmission network, what you are going to create there? So, VS is equal to A beta plus. This equation I can write as Vs minus A into Vr, which is equal to what? B into IR. This IR I can write as IR is equal to because receiving it up and now we are going to write Vr into IR conjugate. So IR is equal to what you can get IR is equal to Vs. If you represented angles Vs and angle, what angle are you representing? Vs and angle? Delta. Vs and angle? Delta. And then B, what angle are you representing? B and angle of beta. B and angle of beta. Minus. A and angle? Alpha divided by B and angle? Beta. Into VR. VR and angle 0 degrees. Load voltage always 0 degrees because of inductive loads. Because measure of inductive loads are and is 0 to the front. Now, if you see weather equation, you can express it as VR is equal to VS by V at an angle delta minus beta, delta minus beta minus mod A by mod B into VR at an angle alpha minus beta, alpha minus beta. This is now if I want to get VS by B, VS by B at an angle beta minus delta minus mod A by mod B. We are at an angle beta minus alpha. Now I need expression for receiving an apparent power. Receiving an apparent power, ISR is equal to VR into pi r angle. Why? Because we are going to get the expression receiving inside power transfer, because power is transfer from source to load. So, load power transfer is generating. So, ISR is equal to ISR. So, VR, VR, at 90 degrees into substituted value by R conjugate. So, IR conjugate value what? VS by B at an angle beta minus delta minus I bar by B bar mod A at an angle beta minus alpha. Now if you simplify this expression, you can get SR is equal to VS VR at an angle beta minus delta divided by B divided by P minus VR square into VR square into mod A by mod B and beta minus alpha beta minus alpha. This is the expression for current power. Now if I need active power, active power PR at receiving side, active power is PR particle, active power in terms of mass. So active power is equal to VR VS by B into cos beta minus delta, cos beta minus delta minus VR square into mod A by mod B into cos beta minus alpha. This is the expression for active power receiving itself. Similarly, reactive power expression. Reactive power. Reactive power. Q is equal to receiving itself. Q is equal to. Equal to what? Mod V S mod V R by B B into sine beta minus delta minus V R square into mod A by mod B into sine beta minus alpha. This is the expression for active power, expression for reactive power. Expression for active power, expression for reactive power, impedance in the line, beyond the length of the line. Now, we got expression for active powers and reactive powers receiving inside. So, after getting these powers, suppose the voltage there are given, see, VRVS, VR, VS. Values are given, phase values, phase values, then respective PR and QR also, facing phase values, single phase. Suppose if VR, comma VS are light variables. Light variables. Then the getting PR and QR, they are getting receiving and acting on the amplifiers are three phase powers. Yeah, phase powers, single phase powers. And these are three phase powers.
Remember, the voltage concerned, voltage is in line values. The getting power is three phase power. But because three phase transmission and voltage ratings, we are going to be putting in line to line values. Line to line RMS values. That's why powers also three phase. If voltage are not phase means, then getting power is also single phase power. But by default, the specification with voltage and transmission line is line to line value. Why? Because we are going to transferring in star connection. And the given power is by default, three phase power. Is about expression for active and then for the active powers at the receiving end side. So these PR and QR are called here. PR and QR are called PR and QR are called equations. Equations are called non-linear algebraic transcendental equations. Important point, remember, transcendental equations. So because nonlinear, those are terms of sine and cosine, not of nonlinear functions. And why we are going to look at transcendental? To understand this, take an example. Suppose if I take an example, some function is given as some x square plus 3x. Another function given as some f2 version, this is f1 version. F2 is equal to some cos x. Given. For this, if you calculate f of f1 dash, what you can get? F1 dash is equal to 3x plus 3. Similarly, f1 double dash, what you can get?
2x.
And f1 triple dash, what you can get? 2 you can get. F1 triple dash, what you can get? This function is closing here. Suppose if you differentiate this 2 dash what you can get minus sine x and f2 double dash what you can get f2 double dash equal to 1 minus cos x and f3 triple dash what you can get again you can get sine x. So but the function only completes. The function doesn't complete for the derivative. These type of functions are called transcendental functions. Transcendental, that equation is called transcendental equation. This type of functions, this type of equations are called non-transcendental equations. Non-transcendental equations, remember these. Okay? So these two equations are called power transfer equations. Power transfer equations. At the receiving end this side. No, we are not like this. Power transfer equations. In this organization, as the first organization, says case 1. With the case 1. To gate. Maximum receiving end power PR max. Generally to get condition for to transfer maximum receiving end power. No doubt to get condition for any equation what you are doing, you have to differentiate the equation with respect to variable. See here, because during disturbance means because of variation of loads, the main variable quantities are terminal voltage, delta, and frequency. These three terms will vary more frequently. That's why these are called states of power system network. States of power system
network, states of power system.
See here, so if you want the resisting and voltage are there, so these two becomes amplified because if it is decreasing, the other is increasing. So this becomes constant, beta is always constant. The parameters are always another constant. Delta is a variable term in this equation. Yes, a lot of constants.
If it doesn't change the any length of the line, if length of the line is varying, then only
all these A, B, D, delta, varies. A, B, alpha, parameters are will change. But length we are not maintaining. We are not changing, length we are going to maintain constant. That's why there is no only the variables. That's why we have to differentiate this with respect to delta and equal to 0. Then we can get the condition for maximum power transfer. Maximum active power transfer. Maximum active power transfer. Now, what is the power expression? Active power expression is active power. If you differentiate that, this thing, we can get the expression as Vs Vr by V by V into differentiated. Differentiation of constant number was minus sine beta minus delta into minus delta is equal to minus 1. And here we have no, there is no delta term. So if there is no delta term, I'm going to put this equation. If there is no delta term, that means the quantity becomes 0 minus 0, which is equal to what? Then this 0 becomes cancel. So 0 becomes 0. Now it becomes this. Take that also becomes 0. So you can give expression as sine beta minus delta is equal to 0. So from this you can write beta minus delta is equal to 0 is 0. So 0 is from this you can write delta is equal to beta. If delta is equal to beta, then only maximum active power, maximum real or active power will transfer to the load. So active power also for the real power, real power, true power, average power, useful power. So in the condition we get maximum power. Now at that condition we have the expression for maximum real power transfer to the load at that condition. Now expression, next what? Expression for real power we are under maximum power transfer condition. So PR is equal to what? Real power PR is equal to what? This is the real power. This is equal to what? Mod Vs mod VR by V into cos beta is equal to delta. So beta minus beta and delta minus delta is equal to what? Cos 0 is equal to what? 1 minus VR square into mod A by mod B cos beta minus alpha. This expression to get maximum, yeah, this expression get maximum power transfer under maximum power transfer condition. This is the real power. Similarly, Q R max. Now, to get QR max, say we have a differentiate this also. So you can get expressions of condition for to transfer maximum reactive power. Next, we have direct expression for QR under maximum real power transfer condition. Transfer condition means whenever the load is receiving max
maximum real power, the time we have to derive expression for QR, expression for reactive power. So expression for reactive power under that condition, for that condition delta is equal to beta, that condition QR is equal to, we got expression for QR, reactive power is equal to mod Vs, mod VR by B into sin beta minus delta. So beta is equal to delta. So sin 0 minus mod A by mod B into VR square, sin beta minus alpha. So this total quantity becomes 1, 0. Total quantity becomes 0. Means the expression for reactive power is minus mod B by mod B VR square into beta minus alpha, which means here, whenever we are transferring maximum, we are getting the maximum real power expression, that time reactive power is 0, means load has to, reactive power is negative, load need to get receive negative reactive power. Negative power means the load has to deliver reactive power. Remember that load has to deliver reactive power. What type of loads will deliver reactive power? We discuss capacitive loads only, we discuss reactive power. But to get under this condition, to get negative reactive power, load must be a capacitive load. Means the transmission line sending power to the load, that is what the load, yeah, to transfer ESCF, to maximum real power if you are sending that time, we have to deliver what? Negative reactive power means negative QR means load need to deliver reactive power. So what type of loads will deliver reactive power? Capacitor, that is load must be capacitive. But what type of loads are having? Resistive loads, inductive loads, practically. But we are not having anywhere capacitive loads practically. So that's why it is not possible to derive, to calculate reactive power under maximum power transfer condition. So for that, to provide this reactive power, the load must be inductive. These are the expression for real and reactive powers to the receiving end side. At the receiving end side, with this knowledge, if we draw the characteristics between real power and the delta, real power and the delta, because of variation of delta one, real power is changing. That's an always independent vertical x-axis and a dependent vertical y-axis. Now, if delta is equal to 0, actually if delta is equal to 0, so what you are getting? Vs is Vr by beta, V minus cos beta minus this. So magnitude you are getting. So magnitude. At least we are getting some magnitude, not 0. Now if my delta has negative, delta has negative, so the delta has negative becomes, this quantity becomes integers. So beta minus half and delta means beta plus delta. If beta plus delta, we are beta minus alpha. Beta minus alpha. Delta should, we don't discuss already practical values. Alpha varies from 0 to 10 degrees. And delta is around approximately 90 degrees. So means this magnitude is, this phase is more, but this phase value is less. If this phase value is less, this mass quantity is more. So this quantity is more compared to this quantity. If this quantity is more compared to this quantity becomes, so total reactive power becomes
negative. So negative plus 5. Instead of starting from 0, that's how we will start.
Next, after that, the delta keep on increases. What happens? Reactive power also
increases. After certain level, increases.
But at exactly 9, 90 degrees it has to increase. But practically, it is not possible. Because delta is at 90 degrees. So, at this condition, delta must be less than 90 degrees. Delta must be less than 90 degrees. Maybe, as of this year, delta is equal to 90 degrees. At this condition, the resistor, what do you mean? dPr max by d delta is equal to 0. So before that, dPr by d delta is what? Less than 0. Greater than 0. Here, dPr by d delta less than 0 means here the system here to get power is what? This condition you can say the system is stable, and this condition you can say the system is unstable. Why? Because if any transmission line, here, sending in power, this is what? Load, delta, real power transfer. If load on the generator increases. Suppose a person is moving with certain speed. If you come to any certain weight, what happens? Speed will get decreases. Similarly, in case of generator also, if load increases, speed what? It decreases. If speed decreases, the variation of delta increases. Because of variation of delta, the real power of delta also we have to increase. Because load increase means we have to send more power. So in this case, system we can come to the stable. But here, if load delta is increases. At that time, if you didn't change input, if PR is not, PR is decreasing, in that condition, system is called unstable system. System is called unstable. That's why the exact curve is not possible. We have to go for approximate model. Again, that is the expression for approximate model of the real power and the reactive power. In that, we will get to define power transfer equation at approximate condition. These are the approximate values. Stop it. We'll see in the next class.